那么，就像刚才基拉奇先生所说的，随着未来英国脱欧，意大利将会成为欧盟第三大经济体。它的加入本身呢，在区域内就是一种象征意义。未来，中国和意大利将会以经贸合作为抓手，加强多领域的深入合作，谱写中意关系的新篇章，同时也迈入中国同西方发达国家经贸合作的新时代。好，我们继续来关注到的是，应国家主席习近平邀请，瑞士联邦主席于利·毛雷尔于4月23号到30号对中国进行国事访问，并且出席第二届“一带一路”国际合作高峰论坛。毛雷尔主席在接受央视记者专访的时候就表示，瑞中两国将会签署一份有关“一带一路”的备忘录。他表示，瑞士明确支持“一带一路”倡议，“一带一路”倡议是连接世界的桥梁，具有前瞻性。好，这就是今天的特别报道，稍后短片之后，请继续收看资讯部分的内容。
Mr. President, nice to meet you. Thank you for accepting my interview. What are your expectations of the meeting with President Xi Jinping? A Belt and Road MOU will be signed during your visiting of China. Could you please share with us more details?
First, this meeting is for the personal relationship. We had this every year with China on a high level. And then we have this MOU. With this MOU, we will find the regulation in third state for enterprises, for companies from China and Switzerland. For example, for financing of projects, for sustainable, for the environment, that we have the same regulation in this case. And I think that's important. And there we can help to support the states, and we can help companies from China and Switzerland. I think that's the idea, clear regulations for clear projects.
What is the prospect of Sino-Swiss collaboration in the next stage, and which fields will be highlighted?
I think we have now, with China, a free trade agreement, 3 years. We will go a step wider in these questions. And then we have not only a trade, we have also some new technologies, artificial intelligence, that we have a great potential for a collaboration with China.
How do you evaluate the BRI? Do you think the BRI has played an important role in the development of the global economy?
Belt and Road Initiative, I think that's one of the most important projects for the economy in the world. And we support this clear. I think we need visions, and China has this vision now from this Belt and Road Initiative. I think that's very important. Trade needs investments. Everything needs first investments, and this is a very big investment project with a lot of smaller projects around the world, we can say. And that's just a bridge from China, from Asia to Europe, to Africa. And I think that's for peoples in this region very, very important. That's more than an economic project. That's a project for freedom. That's a project for relationship between countries, between different culture. And we support this in every case. That's a great project.